Hey guys, my name is Allie Jones, and trust me when I say that I don't always look this bad. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is finally going to be my skincare routine for both daytime and nighttime. The reason why it has taken me so long to do this video is because I am constantly switching in and out to different products, but for the past, I'd say, 6 months, I have just stuck to these products and not have switched any of them out. And I think I found what has been making my skin look clearer and much brighter. So yeah, I'm going to be sharing my daytime and nighttime skincare routine with you guys. And just know that for daytime, I keep it very, very simple because a majority of the time when I wake up and go to school, I'm not wearing makeup. However, when it does come to the nighttime, I do like to wear makeup and I do typically record at night. So my skincare for both day and night are very different. However, these products do work for my face. So if you are interested in seeing how I got clearer skin, I don't really have a lot of bumps on my skin, not a lot of acne scarring, then please continue watching. For my daytime skincare routine, I literally only use 3 products: a cleanser, toner, and moisturizer. And every now and then I will stick in a kind of pimple treatment if it is that time of month and I have a pimple, or if I notice that I'm getting a zit here or there from stress, because your girl is a college student. And in addition to those 3 skincare products, I do like to moisturize my lips all day, every day. And I did put this on before I started the video just because they were looking a little drier than usual. So for my lips, I'm just going to include this. It is the Smith's Rosebud chapstick. I do get this at Sephora and I believe it's around $7. I am trying to use all this because I did just purchase, I believe it's the eucalyptus menthol one, and I use that one about 2 to 3 times and I like it more than this one. However, this one works really, really well. But the reason why I like the menthol one a little bit more is because the way it makes my lips kind of tingle and it has that minty cooling feeling on my lips. But if you're not into that, definitely try the rosebud one. This is like definitely a holy grail product of mine, as you can tell. Every morning when I cleanse my face, I go in with this black bar of soap. You guys are probably looking at me like, what the heck is this? It literally looks like a rock, but it is by the brand Shea Moisture, and I kept the packaging of this soap so I can show you guys. But this is called the Shea Moisture African Black Soap with Shea Butter. Now, this is perfect for someone that has blackheads or acne-prone skin or oily skin in general, and I have been using this for about a year and a half now. This is actually my second bar, and I just opened this about a month ago, and I still like have a lot left. As you can see, I really, really like this soap because it really works for my skin. It helps clear up my blackheads, which I always get along my chin on my face. And just to fill you guys in a little bit about my skin, I do have oily skin, I do get acne, I do get blackheads. However, my skin, I feel like, is starting to transition. I still get the occasional, you know, breakout and the blackheads. However, my oils have been kind of not there on my face. I don't know if it's the products that I'm using or maybe because I'm getting older, but I still really, really like this because it helps with my acne. And I also noticed that this helps with the redness on my face. I noticed after I started using this for a while, my face does not get as red in this region of my face. So plus for that, you can purchase this at Walgreens and at Ulta. I got both bars of soaps when I first had the two. It was buy one, get one half off. So I thought that was a really, really good deal. This is no more than, I believe, like $7.99. So this is so, so good. I first wash my face, obviously. I like to pull my hair back, or if I'm in the shower, just, you know, still pull my hair back so my hair doesn't get wet. And then I will wet my face. Today I will be using a wash towel to do that. So I have some lukewarm water here, and I'm just going to dampen up my face. The reason why I'm using lukewarm water is because I want my pores to be nice and open when washing my face, just so it opens up my pores and the cleanser can get deep into my pores to clean all of the dirt and excess oil out. I'm just going to take that between my hands, and usually in the shower this is much different. I don't have to work as fast just because my face is just running under the shower, but I am going to wet that a little bit more so I can get a little bit more of that soap, and then I am just going to directly, you know, apply that onto my face. I've seen a lot of people use this differently. They like to just take it on their hands like so and then cleanse their face, but I like to just put the bar of soap directly onto my face and then massage it in. And then now to take that off, I'm gonna take that washcloth again, scrub that in a little bit more, and then begin to remove it. I'm going to move on into toning my face, and I have been using the Neutrogena Oil Free Acne Stress Control Triple Action Toner. This is good for treating acne before it even emerges. It eliminates oil and shine and also refreshes and soothes. I do go back and forth between this toner and the other toner that Neutrogena makes. However, I have been looking for a toner that does not have alcohol. I have heard that alcohol is not good for your face, especially when in toners. So if you guys have any recommendations for a toner that does not have alcohol, then please leave that listed down below and I will definitely try it out. But for the meantime, because, you know, I have been using this for a while and I'm almost done, I will finish it up and then switch on over to something else. But the reason why I do like this is because it does have salicylic acne treatment in it. So I really, really like that. So I will pop that open, and on a cotton ball, I will pour a little bit of that on there. And then sweep that across my face. Now that the toner is completely dry on my face, we are now going to move into the acne treatment step of my cleansing process. So I have been really liking the tea tree oil by The Body Shop. I saw someone here on YouTube do this before I saw Desi and Katie and a few other YouTubers do it. And when I saw her first do it, hopefully I can get her name, but when I saw her first do it, I was like, I wonder if that actually works. So I went to Ulta and bought this for, I believe, $5 or $7, and I have not put this down since. So what I like to do with this is first dilute a Q-tip and just a little dot of water. So I actually have some water here. So just a little bit of that onto there. And then I will literally only take like one little drop of the tea tree oil, like so. Then on any pimples or any bumps that I have on my face, I will go and just dot it on my face. Don't go in and like soak your, you know, little crater on your face with this. Just dot it, because this tea tree oil is like potent and will probably burn your skin if you put a lot on. So I do have some bumps right here because that time of the month is coming. So I will just dot that on any little zit I see. And when I say that this works, it works, you guys. Now that the tea tree oil is dry on my face, I'm going to move on to the last step of my daytime skincare routine, and that is to moisturize my face. I really like the CeraVe Moisturizing Lotion for Normal to Dry Skin. I did mention this in a favorites video of mine, and I did say that even though this is for normal to dry skin, I still really, really like it, even though I have oily skin myself. This moisturizer is super, super lightweight and just melts right on into the skin and just absorbs into like every area of your face. So what I like to do is literally take one pump and warm that up in between my fingers like so, and then pat it onto my face first. Make sure I get every area, and then massage it into my face. I do like to take it down my neck as well. This is pretty much it for my daytime skincare routine. I'm gonna go off camera and do my makeup and then come back at the end of the day to remove my makeup and show you guys what I use for my nighttime skincare routine. However, if you guys wanna see what I'm doing in the meantime, then please check out my previous vlog and you guys can see what I did during the day. Obviously, I'm cleaning like always in my vlogs, but just check it out. I did run a few errands and hung out with Eli a little bit, so check that out and then come back to this video and check out my nighttime skincare routine. I am back and it is currently, let's see, it is currently 10:36 and Eli and I, we spent the day, well, like the last half of the day together. We went to go run some errands and then we went to dinner and now we are back home and I am just super super exhausted, so I am now going to take my makeup off and show you guys what that skincare routine includes. So first I'm going to take off my eye makeup, and to do so I am going to be using the Garnier Skin Active Micellar Cleansing Water. It's the all-in-one, removes makeup, cleanses, refreshes, no rinse, no harsh rubbing for face, lips, and eyes. It's for all skin types, even for sensitive. It comes in this clear bottle with the pink cap, and this is 13.5 fluid ounces. I do typically go back and forth between this and a few other like cleansing waters to remove makeup, but for this video I am going to use this one just because I like this one. I like that I don't have to rub so much with this one, and with other ones I do have to rub. To remove my makeup, like I said, I'm going to be using this, but the little tool that I will be using is the MIDI Blackout, and I actually received these from the owner, Amanda, of this company, and it came in this little box here, and this includes 5 superior makeup remover pads. I am obsessed with these. I have been using these for the past, I think 3 months ago. I'm pretty sure around 3 months ago. I actually met Amanda at Generation Beauty San Francisco last year, and I was like, oh my gosh, when she was telling me about these, because these are just so innovative and so cool, and I really, really like these. So what these are, if you don't know what this is a, I'm gonna read like the back of the box. So it's softer, more effective than disposables. So meaning disposable wipes that we typically buy from like Neutrogena or even the Costco brand, Simple, you know, those wipes. These are better because they're reusable and washable. You literally can use one whole pad for both eyes, both sides, which is awesome. They're gentle and non-shedding, which is great as well. They're suitable for lash extensions, it says, which I have never tried that because I don't get lash extensions, but I'm sure they would still work perfectly for that. And then it's perfect for use with your favorite cleansing potions. So this says, there's like a little star next to it, and it says, we think cleanser-free rubbing is a drag on your skin. So, and then it says, pun intended, which is nice. If you guys ever get a chance to check out the MIDI and the website, read the like about me tab, like how the company started and stuff. I really, really like the wording of, you know, how the company came about. I don't know who wrote it. I'm pretty sure Amanda did, but I love the way she worded, you know, where the company originated, how she came up with the idea of it. So if you guys end up checking them out, make sure you check out their Instagram and let them know that I sent you. This video is not sponsored. This is literally the only product that was sent to me. I'm not getting paid to talk about them. I don't have a coupon code or anything like that. I really, really like the MIDI, and I really believe in the company. And they are based in LA, which is awesome. They have a lot of extra fun facts on the box as well, even how to use that. So I'm going to break this MIDI blackout down for you guys and let you guys know how I use it. Even though the MIDI blackout is specifically supposed to be used for your eyes, I do use an extra MIDI to remove my foundation. Now, I don't know if this is allowed, but I really, really like removing all of my makeup using two MIDIs. One for my eyes, both sides, and then one for my face, one for each side. So here is the MIDI. I have been kind of flashing it around as I'm talking about the MIDI, but here it is in all its glory. It is a teardrop or raindrop little mitt, and I really like it because it has these slits in the back, and you could just stick your fingers in like so. It's super easy to work, and it's really, really soft. Like, I am obsessed with how soft it is. So I first like to use kind of, I call it like the butt edge. That's not the correct, you know, that's not the way they named this side, but this is the round side, but I do call it the butt side. So I do take the butt side first, and I like to put some of that Garnier micellar water on there, like so. And then I go in and gently remove my eye makeup. And when I say eye makeup, I remove like my eyebrow makeup as well. And then I do like to take the MIDI and turn it right side up and then remove the makeup that's on my lower lash line. So I'm going to do the same with this eye, except I am going to be using the other side, so the clean side, just so there is no, you know, bacterial transfer between both eyes. So once again, I'm going to apply a little bit of that Garnier micellar water, and then taking that round end again, repeating the same process all the way up to the brow and then on the upper lid. Now, to remove my face makeup, I'm going to be repeating the same steps, except I'm going to be using a clean MIDI blackout. So with the same Garnier micellar cleansing water, just put a little bit of that across like so and get to removing. To cleanse my face after makeup removal, I am going to go in with the Derma E Purifying Gel Cleanser. I got this at Gym Beauty San Francisco, like little samples of it, and after I ran out of those samples, I had to go and run and purchase this. I have been using this since November, and I really, really like it. So I am first going to go in with lukewarm water and wet my face to once again open up my pores, just like I did for my daytime skincare routine. And I'm going to take a nice little squeeze of that, like so. I'm going to rub that in between both hands and start rubbing that into my skin in circular motions. I like using this cleanser specifically for the nighttime because I feel like it gets all of that extra makeup off, and also my skin feels nice and smooth after using this cleanser. This is supposed to detox your face of all of the sweat and excess oils and makeup on your face. So I feel like this is the perfect cleanser for nighttime. So now that that is all rubbed into my face, I'm going to remove that with lukewarm water. While my face is still wet and I'm looking crazy, I'm going to move on in to the next product. And this is another item by Derma E, and this is their Microdermabrasion Scrub. This is so good. If you guys want your skin to be super soft and super clear the next day and bright, use this scrub. So you're supposed to apply this with wet skin and literally take the smallest amount and scrub this into your skin for 1 minute. 1 minute, that's all you need. So, just apply that all over the face and get to scrubbing. Now that it has been up to a minute of scrubbing my face, I'm going to remove that now with lukewarm water. Well, before I finish off my face with a sleeping mask, I first like to apply the Mario Badescu drying lotion. I am sure that if you are into like skincare at all, then you know exactly what this is. This is pretty much an acne spot treatment. If you have any type of zit or pimple coming up, put this on the night before you go to bed. When you wake up in the morning, it will literally almost be gone. I go back and forth between this treatment and I also go to the tea tree oil. I typically like to use the tea tree oil when I have like a huge, huge zit, or if I wake up with one in the morning and I, you know, I obviously can't use this during the day, so I will typically use the tea tree oil. But at night, because I'm just here hanging out with Eli, I will apply the drying lotion. What you do is you take a clean Q-tip and literally dunk that all the way through the liquid down to the pink powder, come back up, and just like that. You don't swirl it around in the bottle, you just literally go straight through the bottle and then come right back up. And I dot this wherever I may have a breakout. And then the last thing I do for my skincare is I apply the Laneige Water Sleeping Mask, and this is for all skin types. I really like using this when I want my face to be brighter and to look more plump. This mask literally makes my face super, super smooth. And I like the smell of this. I don't know what exactly the scent is, but it smells like, I think, a spa would. I've never been to a spa, but if I can choose a scent that a spa would smell like, it would be this scent. So I literally take a small little scoop on the back of my nail and apply that very carefully where I didn't apply that drying lotion. Mainly like to focus this around my nose because I do have dry patches around my nostrils. And then drag that out onto my cheeks. That is it for my daytime and nighttime skincare routine. If you guys enjoyed this video and cannot get enough of me, then please do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and also hit the subscribe button down below. Please let me know if you guys have tried any of these products or if you're interested in any of these products. I will leave every single product linked down below, including the Midi Blackout. If you guys end up checking out the Midi on Instagram, please let them know that I sent you there. I think that's all I have to say for this video. If you guys are interested in any future routine videos like hair care routines or morning routine, nighttime routine, then please let me know down below. I know that this video was long overdue, but better late than never, they always say. So yeah, that's all I have to say, and I will see you guys in my next one. Peace out.